Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to D.G. Will's Books in La Jolla, California. Tonight, we're delighted to have Mary McDonough here to discuss her new memoir, Lessons from the Mountain, What I Learned from Erin Walton. Noted actress and award-winning filmmaker Mary was cast as Erin Walton at age 10 in The Homecoming, the movie of the week that inspired the Emmy Award-winning dramatic series The Waltons. Overnight, her life as a normal kid in a working-class family changed. She left school, friends, and the McDonough family to start a new life of studio classrooms, wardrobe fittings, travel, interviews, photo sessions, and memorizing lines. In the book, Mary shares intimate behind-the-scenes memoirs of Will Gear, Richard Thomas, her two moms, Patricia Neal and Michael Learned, and all the other Walton cast, crew, and guest stars. She discusses what it was like growing up in front of America. After the series ended, Mary details how she tried to reinvent herself with artificial help and almost died. Mary was diagnosed with lupus and was the founding president of Lupus LA. She's the recipient of the National Award for Outstanding Service from the Lupus Foundation of America, and the American Heart Association awarded her the L'Etoile du Cœur Stars of Heart Award for her participation in their Healthy Heart campaigns. Continuing her acting career into adulthood, Mary has appeared on numerous series, including ER, Picket Fences, Will and Grace, American Dreams, Boston Legal, Ally McBeal, The West Wing, and The New Adventures of Old Christine, among others. She has served as a special correspondent for Entertainment Tonight and host of programs for the Travel Channel and the Family Channel as well. She's also an award-winning filmmaker. Ladies and gentlemen, actress and director Mary McDonough.
Thank you.
Thank you, my dear.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. Thank you all for coming out. It's very exciting. So I'm going to tell a little story. About, what is it, 3.5 years ago? I was here, and it was pouring rain, and Patricia Neal was here with Stephen Michael Shear to sign their book, a book about Patricia. And I wandered back, and I said, you know, I might have a book coming out sometime in the future. Can I have a book signing here? And of course, that's why I'm here. So I want to thank you very much. All of these years, what was it, 3 years later, I send you an email and you were delightful and said, sure. So thank all of you. I want to thank all of you for being here and for coming out tonight. I know it's a holiday and so it's very special. I want to acknowledge a couple of people who are here tonight, and you may have some questions for one of them. And first I want to thank my Don for being here because he's so supportive and wonderful. That's my mate. And also, I want to thank Beverly Nault. Beverly, just stand up real quick. Yay! Beverly, we always is called Bev, the mechanical writer, but what really she is in the book is she did all the stuff that I either don't like to do or that I'm not very good at. So all of the, you know, a lot of the research and a lot of the times I'd be writing and say, oh my goodness, there was this thing. I did this show. What was it? And Bev was great because she'd go out and she'd either find out the information and or set me straight. And then she would make it all look very pretty. And I'll do all the things that I don't do very well. So the book would not have happened without you. So I thank you very, very much. And thanks for being here. So if you have any, when we do the questions later, feel free to ask us both questions if you like. I was going to actually, which of course I don't have my glasses with me. So has anybody read the book yet?
Absolutely.
Yay. Oh, yay. Okay. So some of you have and some of you haven't. So, well, here it is. We have our Lessons from the Mountain. And it's funny because of the title, the first thing anybody usually asks me is, what are the lessons? And then I think, wow, there are so many. How do I just boil it down into a few? And then the other question that I get is, how did you decide to write the book and why now? So I think the reason that it's the book is out now is because A, I'm older, and B, I've kind of come through the other side of my mountain. I write about in the book how I always felt that I had to control the mountain, plow through the mountain, climb the mountain, dissect all of every stone on the mountain, examine every boulder, bring in crews to drill through it, and I had to figure it out and know everything, and then everything would be perfect. And I realized that there is no perfect, and that there's no perfection, and that's part of the lesson. And I think I can say this, I'll be 50 in a couple of weeks, and I think having gone through all of the things that I've gone through, and coming out the other side, okay, and I always say I haven't robbed a convenience store yet. Although there's still time. And being a former child performer, so many times people want us to be train wrecks. And I wanted to write a book about something positive, about actually, you know, having a life and coming out the other side, and talk about some of the good that former child performers do. And those are the things you don't see in the news very often. They're not as popular as some of the things that are out there right now. So having gone through life and gone through a lot of challenges, as was mentioned, lupus and some body image issues, and making the mistake of having breast implants, a mistake for me because it made me very sick, I felt that it was time where I could actually put the lessons down. And when I thought about it, I thought, well, where did the lessons come from? And so many of the lessons have come from my own McDonough family and my Walton family. And as I look back and think, well, how did I get through this difficult time? I can always associate it to something that happened on the show, or a lesson that the Walton family learned, or a lesson that the Walton family taught. And because I think part of the reason that I did come out the other side is because I have these two wonderful families, my own McDonough family and my Walton family. And there were a lot of us and a lot of people watching over me. So I think that's part of the reason that I kind of did okay. I had a lot of support. There are a lot of blessings in having grown up the way I did. There were a lot of tough times, and the book definitely talks about, you know, some of the more confusing times, but it also talks about some of the really wonderful behind the scenes antics. And not only on the Waltons, but on other television shows that I did. And it talks about good times and the tough times, but more importantly on how I always circled back and came full circle to my roots. And there were so many wonderful lessons. You know, the Waltons was this sort of family who every week somebody new was coming in, somebody different. We had gypsies, or we had, you know, the Native Americans or Jewish people, or all these different people coming to the mountain. And we learned so many things. And as a kid growing up on the show, I learned about the Depression. I learned about World War II. I learned so many things from the show that it only seemed right to be able to share some of those lessons. So does anybody have any questions? You had a series.
Well, I have a lot of questions. Embarrassing questions.
Oh, embarrassing questions. Okay. Well, I was thinking about, like, I was going to read a little bit of something, but what was your question while I'm trying
I could ask you a non-embarrassing question.
Okay. Non-embarrassing first. How's that?
would you care to reflect upon the